Today I'm going to show you how to control mass flow rate using a back pressure regulator. This is particularly useful in applications where use of a mass flow controller is impractical. Mass flow controller use might be impractical due to high pressures or aggressive chemistries that are not compatible with the mass flow control. We'll start on this side. We have our gas supply pressure coming in. Please note that this could also be a liquid supply pressure coming in. The first thing we're going to do is set the pressure using a pressure reducing regulator here, which sets the P1 pressure. That does a couple of things for us. In the case of a gas, it's particularly useful because it sets the gas density, and that's going to help us pressure compensate this system. The next item is an orifice. The orifice could be a fixed orifice, or in applications where you need more variability in flow rate, this could be a variable orifice. The next item, and we're using an Equilibar back pressure regulator. The back pressure regulator is going to set the upstream pressure, which is P2. Now, between the pressure reducing regulator and the back pressure regulator, I've in effect set P1 and P2, which now allows me to control the differential pressure across the orifice. The Equilibar regulator is pilot operated, and it's being pilot operated by an electronic pressure regulator. This electronic pressure regulator lets me vary the command set point to the Equilibar and therefore vary the P2. By varying P2, I can control the differential pressure across the orifice using the electronic pressure regulator. Now, what really works well about this system is the fact that the back pressure regulator naturally and inherently modulates itself to keep P2 at set point. So regardless of variations in the system, here I've shown the system as a variable orifice, but anything that's variable going on in the system, which would change the system pressure, is sensed and automatically compensated for by the back pressure regulator. So regardless of the downstream pressure and how it varies, P2 remains at set point, and that keeps the mass flow through the system constant. We're going to go out to the lab now and take a look at this actually in practice. Okay, now we're out in the laboratory to see this in action. Just like the schematic, we're going to start over here with a pressure regulator, manual pressure regulator to set the P1 pressure. This is our variable orifice. The P2 pressure monitored here is being set by the Equilibar back pressure regulator. The Equilibar back pressure regulator is being pilot operated by a proportionaire electronic pressure regulator. One addition to the system is this Teledyne Hastings mass flow monitor. It's going to measure the actual flow in the system. It's going to be up here on this display. Right now we're at 1.48 standard liters per minute. The system, the user's system, is being represented by this variable orifice right here. I can increase or decrease the system restriction. So let's go ahead and do that. Right now we're at about zero system restriction. If I slowly increase that restriction. Now this could happen when lines plug up or things like that. We're going to run up. Now we've almost got, we're something about 125 PSI of system restriction now. And if we come back over to our mass flow monitor, we'll see that we're still at about 1.5 standard liters per minute.